Greetings and welcome on this beginning of Holy Week, this Palm Sunday. Let's gather ourselves for a moment of prayer. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus and his disciples had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, the Lord needs them, and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Thanks be to God.
God be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to praise you, Almighty God, for the acts of love by which you have redeemed us through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. On this day he entered the holy city of Jerusalem in triumph and was proclaimed as King of Kings and Lord of Lords by those who spread their garments and branches of palm along his way. Let these branches be signs for us of his victory, and grant that we who bear them in his name may ever hail him as our King and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life, who lives and reigns in glory with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Let us go forth in peace.
God be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, in your tender love for the human race, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to take upon him our nature and to suffer death upon the cross, giving us the example of his great humility. Mercifully grant that we may walk in the way of his offering and also share in his resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty?
Psalm 39. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eyes consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly. For my life is wasted with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction, and my bones are consumed.
I have become a reproach to all my enemies, and even to my neighbors, a dismay to those of my acquaintance. When they see me in the street, they avoid me. I am forgotten like a dead man, out of mind. I am as useless as a broken pot. For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life.
But as for me, I have trusted in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God. My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Make your face to shine upon your servant, and in your loving kindness, save me.
If we were together at church today, we'd be gathered outside with palms, preparing to enter into Holy Week and into the church with shouts of Hosanna. We'd be celebrating the entry of Jesus' entrance into Jerusalem on his last week. From the perspective of the crowd in the story, this is a moment of great hope that Jesus will enter in and deal with all of the turmoil and the brokenness of the world therein. From Jesus' perspective, this is the culmination of his entire ministry. An example of courage that echoes throughout the ages to our own day. I can imagine that as Jesus is riding through that gate into Jerusalem, he would have the words of Isaiah ringing in his ears. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Where are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Jesus' whole ministry is a story of courage, of facing resistance and challenge. When Jesus' own family was fearful that his ministry would get him into trouble. He faced their fear by reaffirming that he was God's teacher in the world. Jesus entered into the lives of vulnerable and lost people, and he faced their vulnerability with healing and forgiveness. When he was threatened with violence for upsetting the religious status quo, he faced into the resistance with a reminder that the law of love is always the guiding principle in following God. 2,000 years before Sheryl Sandberg's popular book, Jesus was leaning into the turmoil of the world with truth and grace and love. And that's been the call for Christians ever since. To face the varied changes and challenges of every age with courage and hope. And that's got me thinking about what it means to be entering Holy Week in the time of pandemic. What immediately comes to mind are doctors and nurses and ambulance drivers and nursing home attendants. Or courageous political leaders and community leaders who have had the courage to upset the status quo to protect the vulnerable. Less visible are all those people who are still working to support us in our life, like grocery clerks and food bank workers. All in their own way, riding to the rescue. And to them I say, Hosanna, blessed are you who come. And whether you know it or not, you are God's servants working in this time. But what about all of us staying at home? What does it mean for us to face the chaos of the world? What does it mean for us to welcome hope in this particular time? What does it mean to be retired and at home and lean into the turmoil? What does it mean to be a teacher or a parent, homeschooling, or a student? What does it mean to be a courageous and hopeful you in the midst of pandemic? Jan Kwiatkowski shares what it was like serving as a hospice chaplain. When she tells people this was the happiest time of her life, most people look at her and wonder how she could do that work. And she says it's because she learned the most courageous things about living. She learned them from the dying. I learned about a different kind of courage, she says, a kind of courage that shows up in small and specific ways, in the small and specific choices we make every day in our lives. A kind of courage that shows up and is present in the big and little joyful and agonizing moments of life. She goes on, I learned that those who live from a stance of courage move forward to the end of life in a completely different way than those who live from a stance of fear. And she gives an invitation to show up and be present in every moment, to come from a stance of courage and not fear. Courage doesn't mean that there aren't frightening things happening, that there aren't threats out there, maybe even death. But being courageous means not letting fear get in the way of acting with love. It means that even knowing that things will be hard and dangerous and uncertain, we still ride into the turmoil. Each day, each little moment, asking what it is that God is calling me to do right here for the sake of love. Actually, being in a pandemic is the perfect place to walk through Holy Week. Because Holy Week isn't primarily about remembering what Jesus did 2,000 years ago. It's about what it means to be Jesus for the world in this very moment. It's about doing the loving, patient, self-forgetful thing despite the uncertainty of the moment. with the faith and the knowledge that Christ is a courageous presence entering every soul. Though we're not together today, I'm grateful to be sharing this week and the many weeks that lie ahead with this courageous community. Let's face this moment, each of us, from a stance of courage and love. Let's lean in. Let's set our faces towards the challenges that will come. Let's answer whatever calling is being given to us at this time, confident that God will be with us. Let us go forth in the name of Christ, with the promises of God carrying us along.
Prayers of the people. We stand with Christ in our prayer. For Christian people everywhere who minister to the suffering, that we may bear witness through our prayer and action to the love of Jesus. Let us pray. For the wisdom of our leaders in this difficult time, that our common life may be ordered in justice, compassion, and mercy, let us pray. For those who still make Jerusalem a battleground, and for the peace of Jerusalem, let us pray. for those who have the courage to work directly with those who are suffering from the coronavirus, that they may be protected and sustained. Let us pray. For all those forced to stay at home while this pandemic spreads, particularly we remember those in the darkness and agony of isolation, that they may find support and encouragement. Let us pray. For those weighed down with hardship, failure, or sorrow, especially those who are out of work, let us pray. We remember those in our lives who need healing, comfort, and support. Let us pray. For all those who have died, that they and those they love may know the mercy of God. Let us pray.
Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, sending you forth into the life that God is calling you into, to be a person of love and courage. Amen.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining us this Palm Sunday, brought to you by my home office and my prayer space. We just have a few quick announcements. One, thank you to everybody who's been contributing these past few weeks to our services. It's such a joy to see everyone. On that note, please join us for virtual coffee hour. The Zoom meeting IDs will be posted maybe right here for 8:45 and 10:45. So please join if you can. If you can't do video conferencing, there are phone lines that are available. We'll post the telephone number right there too. And then you can just put in the meeting ID and join us. So that's this Sunday. And the final announcement is Holy Week. It's coming. And we continue to be in our homes. So for those of you who have been paying attention to our newsletters and our communication, we've been preparing for church in our homes. Thomas's letter will go out. Hopefully by Tuesday, we'll send you an email. Also with all the service bulletins for Holy Week, which includes Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, Holy Saturday, and we'll probably put Easter Sunday service in there too. Every video will be posted each day onto our YouTube playlist, so keep that refreshed and pray together. We hope that Holy Week continues to be a time of deep prayer and deep consideration for the mystery of God in this world of ours. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, help us this day to understand and celebrate your dream for the world, to be transformed in Jesus' love, in particular his life, death, and resurrection we are celebrating this week, and to use our gifts to make a difference for others. Amen.